again, and welcome to another bone-chilling edition of Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark. Like always, it's time to turn down the lights and prepare yourself. Sounds. The house was near the beach. It was a big old place where nobody had lived for years. From time to time, somebody would force open a window or a door and spend the night there, but never longer. Three fishermen caught in a storm took shelter there one night. With some dry wood they found inside, they made a fire in the fireplace. They lay down on the floor and tried to get some sleep, but none of them slept that night. First, they heard footsteps upstairs. It sounded like there were several people moving back and forth, back and forth. One of the fishermen called, "Who's up there?" The footsteps stopped. Then they heard a woman scream. The scream turned into a groan and died away. Blood began to drip from the ceiling into the room where the fishermen huddled. A small red pool formed on the floor and soaked into the wood. A door upstairs crashed shut, and again the woman screamed, "Not me!" she cried. It sounded as if she was running, her high heels tapping wildly down the hall. "I'll get you!" a man shouted, and the floor shook as he chased her. Then silence. There wasn't a sound until the man who had shouted began to laugh. Long peals of horrible laughter filled the house. It went on and on and on until the fishermen thought they would go mad. When finally it stopped, the fishermen heard someone coming down the stairs dragging something heavy that bumped on each step. They heard him drag it through the front hall and out the front door. The door opened, then it slammed shut. Again, silence. Suddenly, a flash of lightning filled the house with a green blaze of light. A ghastly face stared at the fishermen from the hallway. Then came a crash of thunder. Terrified, they ran out into the storm. The Dead Man's Hand. The students at the school for nurses got along quite well with one another. Well, except for Alice. The trouble with Alice was she was perfect. At least, that's how it seemed to the other students. She was always friendly and always cheerful. Nothing ever upset her. Her school assignments were always on time and always perfect. She didn't even bite her fingernails. Many of the student nurses resented Alice. They would have liked to see her fail at something, become frightened or cry or do something that showed she had weakness like they did. One night, several students tried to frighten Alice with a practical joke. They borrowed the hand of a corpse they had been studying in anatomy and tied it to the light cord in her closet. When she tried to turn on the light, she would find herself holding a dead man's hand. "That would scare anybody," one of them said. "If it doesn't scare her, nothing will." After tying the hand in place, they went to the movies. When they got back, Alice was asleep. But when they didn't see her the next morning, they decided to find out what had happened. There was no sign of Alice in her room, but they soon found her. She was sitting on the floor in her closet, staring at the dead man's hand and mumbling to herself. Alice didn't even look up. The joke had worked, but nobody was laughing. A Weird Blue Light. Late one night in October 1864, Confederate blockade runner slipped by some Union gunboats at the entrance to Galveston Bay in Texas and made it safely to port with its cargo of food and other necessities. Lewis Billings, the master of the small vessel, was getting ready to weigh anchor when he was startled by a shriek from one of his crew. "A strange, old-fashioned schooner with a big black flag was rushing down on us," Billings said later. "She was afire with a sort of weird, pale blue light that lighted up every nook and cranny of her. The crew was pulling at the ropes and doing other work, and they paid us no attention, didn't even glance our way. They all had ghastly, bleeding wounds, but their faces and eyes were those of dead men." The man who had shrieked had fallen to his knees, his teeth chattering as he gasped out for prayer. Overcoming my own terror that was chilling the very marrow of my bones, I rushed forward, shouting to the others as I ran. Suddenly, the schooner vanished before my eyes. Some say that was the ghost of Jean Lafitte's pirate ship Pride that sank off Galveston Island in 1821 or 1822. She was seen again in 1892 in the same waters, with the same crew.
Galveston, oh Galveston, I still hear your sea winds blowing. I still see her dark eyes glowing. She was 21 when I left Galveston.